Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
Good morning. Today's Mass will be offered by the following people: David Morehouse, Annie Ho, Zadie Nan Nguyen, Maria Nan Dim, Stephen Sun Lejeune, Andrea Beth Lejeune, and Doug Roberts. For our priests and seminarians, the Reverend River Richard Fogg and seminarian Nicholas Gray. Please rise for the judgment. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she is conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, and now at the hour of our death. Amen.
We hold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be gentle to me, Lord, and to our word.
And the word was made flesh.
And dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray.
Pour forth this speech, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we too will be the incarnation of Christ, thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel. May God's death and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you in peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us take a few moments and call to mind our sins, asking the Lord for his pardon and his peace. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, to give us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. God our Father, who called St. Francis Xavier Cabrini from Italy to serve the immigrants of America, by her example, teach us to have concern for the stranger, the sick, and all those in need. And by her prayers, help us to see Christ in all men and women we meet. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. John. I rejoice greatly to find some of your children walking in the truth, just as we were commanded by the Father. But now, David, I ask you, not as though I were writing a new commandment, but the one we have heard from the beginning. Let us love one another. For this is love, that we walk according to his commandments. This is the commandment you heard from the beginning, in which you should walk. Many deceivers have gone out into the world, those who do not acknowledge Jesus Christ as coming in the flesh, such as the deceitful one and the Antichrist. Look to yourselves that you do not lose what you worked for, but may receive a full recompense. Anyone who is so progressive as not to remain in the teaching of the Christ does not have God. Whoever remains in the teaching has the Father and the Son. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Blessed are those whose ways blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord.
Blessed are they who follow the law.
Blessed are they who observe his decrees, who seek him with all their heart.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the
Lord. With all my heart I seek you. Let me not stray from your commands.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Within my heart I treasure your promise, that I may not sin against you.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Be good to your servant, that I may live and keep your words.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Open my eyes, that I may consider the wonders of your law.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today's first reading comes to us from 2 John, which I'm sure that all of you know is the shortest book in the entire Bible, containing only 13 verses. But I hope that we were all paying attention to this reading, because I think in a very real way it shouts powerfully and profoundly to us and this age. Listen to what he says again. He says, many deceivers have gone out into the world, those who do not acknowledge Jesus Christ as coming in the flesh. Such is the deceitful one and the Antichrist. And then he goes on. And listen to these words. Anyone who is so progressive as to not remain in the teaching of Christ does not have God. Wow. Wow. That's almost prophetic in our day and age, isn't it? Because we think ourselves, and I say us, I mean our culture and our society, we think ourselves intelligent, wise. Many discoveries have been made. Science has made huge advancements to the point where many people today believe that we don't need God or God is outdated. Really? Really? You know, I had an interesting conversation a couple of years ago with a friend of mine who is a professed atheist, and I kept telling him he's a professor at UL, and he says, you know, I'm an atheist. I said, no, sir, you're not. And he said, well, why not? And I said, well, you're not intelligent enough to be an atheist. Because it takes a tremendous amount of intelligence to make the jump from science to know God. Because science gets to a point where it can explain everything, but then it gets to that one point where it can't cross the line. Can't just find that one thing, right, that makes God non-existent and irrelevant in our lives. And so they end, most atheists end with, when they get to that line, right, they say, and you say, well, you know, what's next? And then they're stuck. They're stuck. And so they have to admit at some point, because that's the way that your God made it. That's the way that your God made it. Ladies and gentlemen, we are never going to be so progressive that we explain away God. God is always going to be the center and focus of our world. He's always going to be that. Why? Because there's a divine design to the world. There's a divine design. It was created by God, and it follows a very specific design path, regardless of what science wants to teach us or tell us. And I would ask you to remember that. You know, in the past election that we just had, you know, it was, we saw this battle playing out, especially mainstream media, about being progressive. Okay, we're never going to be so progressive as a culture and as a society where we don't need God. And any form of government that attempts to negate God is doomed to fail. It's doomed to fail. And we have to keep that in our minds, that nothing, no system of government, no person will ever be able to replace God
in the design of our world and in directing it towards something greater than ourselves. So let's keep that in focus here. You know, it's, and I don't want to go on and on, but we just have to really stop and take a moment of pause in our culture and in our society today. Because no matter how hard we work, no matter how hard we try to replace God with the human person, that's never going to work. It's never going to work, and it's going to fail. Ladies and gentlemen, let's be true disciples of Jesus Christ. Let's be true disciples of the Lamb. Let's live our lives knowing deep within the recesses of our heart how merciful, how kind, how loving, how compassionate God is. Because we have experienced it in our lives. And then let's go out. Let's go out into the world and show it to people in our community, in our country, in our state, that so desperately needs to see it. Because a country without God is doomed to fail. You don't have to believe me. Just look at history. What happened to the Roman Empire? Failed. What happened to Nazi Germany? It failed. What happened to the Soviet Union? It failed. Okay, how many times are we going to see this happen and not realize what's happening? A change needs to be made in our world, and it's going to start with each of us. May our God be with us.
Amen.
Let us stand now and offer our prayers and petitions. For Francis, our Pope, for Douglas, our Bishop, and for all who hold and teach the Catholic faith that comes to us from the Apostles, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our president and all government leaders, and all those that have been called to lead and serve, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all travelers by land, air, and sea, for our prisoners, and for those unjustly deprived of freedom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who are sick and suffering, that they will one day feel the healing hand of God in their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who have died, especially those who will die this day, that the Lord in his love and mercy may open for them the gates of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord our God, hear the prayers that your people offer with all of their hearts, and never abandon the people who share your life. This we ask through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread that we offer you, which earth has given in human hands that made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine that we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Thank you. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we proclaim your wonders, O Lord, in the Virgin and Saint we celebrate today, we humbly implore your Majesty that as her merits are pleasing to you, so too our beautiful service may find favor in your sight, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example leads us to courage, their fervent prayers sustain us in all that we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we do give you thanks. As in exaltation, we proclaim.
Holy,
so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. For it is through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. Renewed by partaking in this divine gift, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of Saint Blessed Francis Xavier Caprini, you may teach us concern for the stranger. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.